Today we'll explore the automatic step-by-step startup procedure of a 50 megawatt Francis turbine and its synchronization with the grid. You'll follow the turbine's journey from a complete stop to generating 25 megawatts of synchronized power. At key steps covered in this tutorial, 1. Main inlet valve opening, 2. Servo-motor lock disengagement, 3. Wicket-gate operation, 4. Turbine startup from zero power, 5. Transition from no-volt state to no-load state, then from no-load state to 25 megawatt synchronization with the grid. Now let's dive into the complete step-by-step process. Step 1. Main inlet valve opening. The operator initiates the startup sequence command and the main inlet valve starts to open. As the main inlet valve, a critical gateway controlling water flow from the reservoir, gradually opens, a controlled stream of water enters the spiral casing of the Francis turbine. This marks the first crucial step in bringing the unit to life. Step 2. Servo motor lock disengagement, enabling wicket gate movement. The servo motor lock, a vital safety mechanism that secures the wicket gates during shutdown, is disengaged. This action frees the wicket gates, allowing them to move and precisely regulate water flow to the turbine runner. With the wicket gates now operational, the stage is set for the Francis turbine to begin operation. Step 3, wicket gates open, initiating turbine rotation. The servo motor actuates, gradually opening the wicket gates to a preset position. This allows water to flow toward the Francis turbine runner with precision. As water strikes the runner blades, its kinetic energy is converted into mechanical energy, causing the runner to rotate. The unit is now officially on its way to power generation. Step 4, speed ramping, approaching the no-volt state. The unit's speed steadily increases from 59% to 90% of synchronous speed without any alarms. At this stage, the generator is spinning but not yet producing voltage, a condition known as the no-volt state. The unit is now at 90% speed in a no-volt state and primed for excitation. Excitation system activation, voltage generation commences. The system activates the excitation system. A DC current is applied to the generator rotor, creating a magnetic field within the stator windings. The interaction between the spinning rotor and the magnetic field induces voltage in the generator. The control screen updates showing voltage rising to 11 kV, a clear sign that the generator is now producing electricity. The unit's speed continues to climb toward 100% as the excitation system stabilizes the voltage output. Voltage generation has begun and the unit is nearing full operational speed. Step 6. Unit reaches 100% speed, preparing for synchronization. With the unit now at 100% synchronous speed, the system automatically fine-tunes key parameters to ensure a seamless connection to the grid. Voltage matching. The generator's voltage is precisely adjusted to align with the grid's 11 kV, as displayed on the control screen. Frequency stabilization. The unit maintains a steady 50 Hz, ensuring synchronization with the grid standard. Phase angle alignment. that the generator's phase angle is synchronized with the grid to enable a smooth connection. Once all parameters are optimized, the GCB close ready status on the control panel turns green, signaling that the generator circuit breaker GCB is ready to close. The unit is now fully spun up, generating stable voltage and ready for synchronization. Step 7, synchronization, connecting to the grid at 2.5 megawatts. With all synchronization parameters aligned, the generator circuit breaker, GCB, is closed, officially connecting the unit to the grid. The generator is now fully synchronized and seamlessly integrated into the power network. As power flow begins, the unit delivers an initial load of 2.5 megawatts to the grid. And step 8, load ramp up to 20 megawatt. The operator increases the load to 20 megawatt, adjusting the wicket gates for greater water flow. Over the next few minutes, power output rises from 2.5 megawatts to 20 megawatts, with all parameters remaining stable. Step 9, final load increase to 25 megawatts. A further command raises the load to 25 megawatts, with the turbine adjusting accordingly. Within 90 seconds, the unit stabilizes at full operation with no alarms. Step 10, steady state monitoring. The system maintains stable voltage, frequency, and cooling, ensuring reliable 25 milliwatts power generation.